Hamilton has a massive question in terms of who is and is not playing. Your quarterbacks, you've been playing two who have struggled to remain healthy over the last couple of years and this season. What are you doing in terms of your utilization of your quarterbacks for Hamilton?
Hamilton cats are in a very interesting situation with their quarterbacks, right? Because look, they've had a guy in Schultz who didn't play the whole season, but has contributed throughout the season. Whenever he was healthy, was helping the team tremendously. Obviously, Bo Levi Mitchell, who was the poster child, who was the guy who was supposed to take him to the promised land at home and play in the Grey Cup, obviously had some injuries. Now, the last few games or two games, he's had an opportunity to start. So clearly, they've made their decision. This is going to be Bo Levi starting. In my opinion, that's what I see. It's going to be Bo Levi Mitchell who's starting the game. But having both guys, especially in this game, I'd go a status quo. I'd go exactly how I did last week and let you guess what I'm going to do in the actual playoff game. But I would start, at least that's what I'm expecting if I'm Montreal Alouettes. I'm expecting to see Bo Levi Mitchell start the game and then finally see Schultz to finish it off. But as a Hamilton Tiger Cats, you want to put Bo Levi there one more time just to make sure he has a good feel. Because at the end of the game, at the end of the day, look, when you play football, you want to know what it feels like to get hit. You want to know what it feels like to not just take a hit, but give a hit as well. And then as a quarterback, you want to be able to have the timing with your offensive players, with your receivers. What I foresee in the playoff game, if Bo Levi continues to progress and continues to produce, they are going with him the whole game.
Yeah, no, can't do it. Taylor Power, go have yourself a day, my guy. Listen, Bo Levi Mitchell knows what it's like to be hit. He knows too well. My guy has been on the 6-game injury list twice in an 18-game season. So I need to get to the finish line with him upright and as healthy as much as possible. And the same goes for Schultz because he's one play away. You get the timing and the reps. You'll get them all week in practice. You can get one reps all week. Sorry, that sucks for you, pal. You're going to still get three reps, but that's the way life goes. Playing 2.5 or 3/4 of this game is not going to improve his timing with his receivers that much at this point, I don't believe. So I want to make sure I get to the finish line with those guys healthy. Remember, this guy is on big money. And the Grey Cup this year is where?
It isn't Hamilton, but DB, you got to remember this. Take into consideration, yes, we know what Bo Levi has done. We know Bo Levi is a future Hall of Fame. We know all of that. But he's on a new team in the first year on a new team. Chemistry matters. It absolutely matters. You can say all you want about practices. I need to see it happen on the field in order for me to also have the same confidence level when we go into the playoff
game. What's the chemistry going to be like when he's at McMaster Hospital getting some x-rays?
No, that's not going to happen.
What do you mean it's not going to happen?
You're going to avoid that, absolutely. I mean, what if it happens in the day of playoff game? Because it's clearly already happened, but I need you to have chemistry going into the playoff game.
If it happens in a playoff game, the season's over anyways.
I mean, so then you have Schultz.
Okay, but you're trying to get to the playoffs with the most optimal chance to win. Let's look at the two injuries he had. Non-contact, rolling, throwing, and a QB sneak to end the game. Like, we need to literally bubble wrap him and get him to the postseason.
I mean, if you're looking at him from that perspective, why did we sign you then? Why did we take you? Why did we bring you?
I don't have a time. To me? I don't have a time machine. You want to know why we signed
you're saying we already got you here and we're seeing that you're like glass right now?
To answer your question, why did we sign him? For this time of year, right now. This is why we signed him. So to do anything that jeopardizes him running out of the tunnel without a limp in the first playoff game, to me, would be malpractice. There's zero chance I'm letting this man take a snap.
Maybe I'm not letting him take a QB sneak at the end of the game again. I've learned my lesson. But at the end of the day...
You're going to stop him from rolling right and pulling his groin?
No. At the end of the day, to me, when you're looking at the Hamilton Tiger Cats and Bo Levi Mitchell situation, I'm letting him go because I want him to continue to develop. The little bit of time that we have left in this season, I want you to continue to develop that chemistry because chemistry, in my opinion, is one of the main reasons why they're in the situation that they are right now. The lack of chemistry at the beginning of the season, Bo Levi being on a new team with a new system, with new receivers, he had to develop that, and he never really got the chance to do so.
One of the reasons why they're in the situation is because this guy wasn't healthy all year.
That's right. But the beginning, he played, what, the first two games of the season before he got his first injury? That's right. It happened at BMO Field. He did not have the chemistry that I've seen him have with his past receivers, obviously being in Calgary for the longest time.
I hope anyone who's has you on the board as a assistant GM, GM, defensive coordinator is not listening to this. I hope they didn't listen to your take about knocking the ball down and instead of trying to intercept it. They're not listening. So let me just actually put this in terms that'll make it very crystal clear. Mm-hmm. If your livelihood depends on the Hamilton Tiger Cats winning, let's just say a postseason game, one solitary postseason game, and you're in this situation, we're putting all the chips in the middle of the table, your entire salary depends on it, you got to go home to Jess and your beautiful children, and you're going to say, you know what, it was this meaningless game, it's not going to change anything other than the final statistics of individual stats, but I'm cool, go ahead and have those 275-pound 4.45 guys run at you for 3 hours. You are comfortable putting all the chips in the table, your entire salary in the middle of the table, with a playoff game essentially in the balance. You're comfortable doing that.
I absolutely am comfortable, DB. It's happening in the next week. And if you're not able to handle that this week, what makes you say that it's going to happen next week? And so I'm putting Bo Levi Mitchell. But here's the other caveat as well, DB, is that what is Coach O going to do with the receiver? I'm talking Tim White. I'm talking to all the other contributors as well. I'm going to give them some time on the field, but as little time as I'm giving them is the same amount of time that I'm giving Bo Levi Mitchell on the field so he can develop, again, that chemistry that I think is absolutely vital for them going forward.